1961, as I said, I was promoted to the position of assistant superintendent of the National Capitol Parks. My prime job was functioning as chief of administration, or I was assistant superintendent for administration. There's one other assistant superintendent, and he was in charge of architecture, engineering, that sort of thing. I had budget personnel and all the things that go with that, including responsibility for the furniture, silver, portraits, everything in the White House. We stored all that for the White House.
Was that assigned to you all by the chief usher? Isn't he legally responsible for that and bonded?
He was legally responsible for it, but we maintain the inventory for everything. And for that purpose, we used a building in Fort Hunt, which was very inadequate for the purpose. Believe me, very, very inadequate. That's where Mrs. Kennedy found some things that eventually ended up in the White House. But during the time that I was responsible for this, I arranged to take over a warehouse from the Air Force, Army Air Corps at that time, in Alexandria. And that was a great, great change for the better, because it was nearby, among other things. Eventually, the Park Service built a special warehouse to accommodate all this stuff in Maryland, where it reposes now in air-conditioned circumstances, and of course it's very well protected now.
Well, the original, I don't think anyone's ever recorded this, the original one at Fort Hunt, was it just like an attic or something?
Building.
Just a warehouse stuffed with were they antiques or just anything from the White House?
Everything was there. All the White House stuff was there, which wasn't in use in the building itself.
So some of the historic stuff was there,
too. It was done in a very shabby way, really. I was surprised that the Park Service hadn't done a better job of looking after that.